Hi everyone. Today we're going to spend the time to talk about exam preparation and readiness. Before we do that, let's take a look at how exam questions have evolved. In the initial years, exam questions tend to be knowledge and fact-based. There will be some questions that need applications. Most of them are pretty straightforward. There will be a certain type of questions that will need a unique technique in terms of how the knowledge could actually be applied. And rarely will you get questions that is actually problem-based type, meaning to say they will give a real-life problem and then you have to use whatever knowledge that you learn to apply on them. Even when such questions are set, they tend to be of a single topic. But nowadays, exam questions have evolved. They have went on to ask fundamental questions or simple questions to ask you to explain certain general trend or certain concepts that you have learned. But they will emphasize on how come there are anomalies. There are examples that do not follow the general trend, or there are examples that do not conform to the concept that you have learned. To add on, there are also data analysis questions now. These questions will basically give you a lot of information, and the questions that's been asked will actually be multi-topic in nature, which means that when you look at a question, you're not quite sure as to whether the questions come from which topic or which piece of data should you be considering. Finally, one new area of questions that is appearing is that they're beginning to teach you new knowledge in the exam hall. They will give you the concepts, they will even give you the example. And from there, and from learning these concepts and these examples on site in the exam, you will then be asked to how you can actually apply them. In order to prepare ourselves for these challenging exam questions, how do we prepare for exam then? Remember the 10,000 hour rule? Remember the first time when you started learning something? The first 10 hours will always be the most difficult. You will have faces a lot of challenge. Things will be a grind. But you need to stick on and persevere to it. When you hit the 100 hours, things will become a bit better. You will still face a lot of challenges and there will still be a lot of grinding to be done. But the very moment when you hit 1,000 hours, you will kind of like be getting into the flow of it and understanding how questions could be managed, how you should pick up knowledge. So typically, we actually advise students to focus on building the learning momentum. That we typically coin as a phase one. During the phase one, the focus is to be able to build a learning momentum such that you enjoy the learning. You will then be able to learn the knowledge, and from the knowledge, you understand how it can be applied. And more importantly, how those knowledge could all come together to help to explain certain things that we observe. Building the learning momentum is critical when you're learning any new subject or anything new. Maybe any topic, any subtopic. The important thing is that the more hours you put into it, the better you're going to get at it. Once you build the learning momentum, you then need to think about moving to the phase two, which is specifically to understand core examination area and marking scheme. So it's not really all about just the knowledge alone, but you need to start to see that how the knowledge could actually be used for you to apply onto exam questions, and which are the areas that are specifically more important and more likely to be tested. And one of the phrases I typically use will be that, what are the fashionable exam questions? The more you're in line with that, the deeper end of the phase two you will get, and the more prepared you are for exam. Finally, the students need to prepare to get into phase three. Phase three is to be exam ready, and in order to be exam ready, student needs to build up their academic fitness and mental fitness. Let me talk about academic fitness first. Whatever core examination area that you've been learning, the marking scheme that you've been learning, in actual fact, you are actually building basically a bag of tools. The tools that you can use for exam. And the exam questions are actually providing you information. And sometimes I say that the exam questions are in fact the batteries. They are the batteries that you need to take. You need to take the correct battery to fit into the correct tool. And from then, you can actually solve and crush the question. So what happens is that if you don't practice sufficiently, you will find that students may actually stumble because when they read the questions, they may not understand the questions and therefore they are unable to identify the correct tool to use them. Conversely, you could also have a case whereby there are tools that the student did not know or have not learned that it could be applied in that manner. So practicing a range of very difficult questions is very important. And therefore, in order to build up the academic fitness, students need to work on questions they do not know, work on questions that they have not seen before, and be exposed to as wide a range of questions as possible. And the wrong thing to do is to continue to work on an area that you're very good at. Although that tends to give a lot of confidence and a feel-good factor for the students, but that is the wrong approach. More importantly, after you build a range of tools, you need to organize them. Organize them in a way that you don't get yourself confused, that you have to ensure that 2A and 2B are distinctly different. And when do you need to use each of them or together? And it is critical that, again, that as the questions evolve now, to be more multi-topical in nature, the more important it is for you to build up your tool bag and organize them with actually some form of fine touch, that you know that if the questions are asking specifically about certain area, then you've got to dive deep and say that it is 2A and 2B that cannot be used. The other bit is also to start to practice a lot on data analysis question, as I've mentioned earlier. A lot of these questions now present a lot of information. You have to be very clear. When the exam questions give you a numerical data, you have to start asking, why did they give me that? The other thing to ask about is that certain questions will highlight certain information in bold. And you certainly have to ask, why are those information in bold? And it's also important, the more you understand why information is given to you, the better you will then be able to pick up the tool and fit it and to be able to solve the questions. Finally, I'll now come to the part whereby I talk about mental fitness. Mental fitness is extremely important. I've seen students who are very bright, who understand a lot of the concepts very well, able to practice and solve questions during practice time. And they are very bright. However, when they go for exam, they are unable to perform as well. To me, that's mental fitness come into play. Mental fitness means that when you are actually preparing for exam, you should be doing multi-topical mock paper within time constraint, not doing your questions, walking one round, eat a potato chip, listening to music. You shouldn't. It should be actually condensed. It should be simulated as per real exam. And the students need to start to build up the fitness. When they encounter a question that's difficult, they should know also when to let it go. Because by devoting all the time into it, it means there are less time for questions that they know how to do. So when I talk about mental fitness, it also has a lot to do with being disciplined. Knowing that these questions may take a lot more time and could potentially suck me in and basically messing up all my time management. In that case, they must be very disciplined to tell themselves, however eager they are to complete the questions, they have to let it go and move on to the next questions. And also the next part is that they should not be affected by certain questions that they see and they haven't seen it before. And it is quite typical in a lot of exam papers, the first question is said to be extremely hard. And the students haven't seen the type of questions before and they get nervous. And from then onwards, they are affected by the rest of the question. Learners and exam takers need to understand this. If the questions is very difficult, every other exam takers is also facing the same challenging questions as you. Your focus is to make sure you actually do those questions that you know first. Get all the marks first. then you should then be able to develop the mental fitness to look at questions that you do not know and to learn the skill as to how best to squeeze the marks out from those questions. By again, leveraging on the experience that you have built because you have practiced a lot of papers, by leveraging on all the core examination area that you have known. Some of the examination area that you know in the paper that have not been asked yet could likely be tested in these questions that you're now looking at. So finally, to conclude, in order to do well for exam, students need to undertake three phases. The first phase is remember to actually build the learning momentum. Remember the 10,000 hour rule. The first 10 hours will always be the most difficult. The longer you hang in there, the better things will become. The better things will become, the more confident you will get. Once you build the confidence, quickly move to phase two. Think about actually exam scheme. Think about the core examination area. Think about marking scheme. Think about understanding what examiners like to ask you. And what are the fashionable questions? What are the things that you know every year after year they are asking? You have to hone your skills and make sure you're really good at it. Once you have completed more or less into that phase, you have to quickly move into phase three. Typically, phase three is months before exam. You have to start to build up your mental fitness by doing rehearsal run of mock papers within time constraint, given the pressure, be disciplined, and also at the same time, building up your academic fitness. All the hard work that you have done, building up your tool bags, the bag of wonderful tools that you've used, understand the bag of wonderful tools that you have built because you understand these are the core examination area. These are the core techniques that you need to use when you apply a certain knowledge. But more importantly, you need to exercise those tool bags that you have because you need to keep it warm so that you are actually very skilled. And more importantly, you need to organize the tool bag so that you won't get confused and you won't fumble into the exam hall. With that, I wish everybody the very best in your preparation for the exam. And thank you for taking the time to listen to us. Thank you.